peptides that bind to MHC class 1 molecules are actively transported from the cytosol to the endoplasmic reticulum. The antigen fragments that bind to MHC class 1 molecules are typically derived from viruses that take over the cell's biosynthetic mechanisms to make their own proteins. All proteins are made in the cytosol. The polypeptide chains of proteins destined for the cell surface, which include both classes of MHC molecule, are translocated during synthesis into the lumen of the endoplasmic reticulum. Here, the chains must fold correctly and assemble with each other if necessary before the complete protein can be transported to the cell surface. Thus, the peptide binding site of the MHC class 1 molecule is formed in the lumen of the endoplasmic reticulum and is never exposed to the cytosol. This raised the question, how are peptides derived from viral proteins in the cytosol able to bind to MHC class 1 molecules for delivery to the cell surface? The first clues came from mutant cells with a defect in antigen presentation by MHC class 1 molecules. Although both chains of MHC class 1 molecules are synthesized normally in these cells, the MHC class 1 proteins are present at abnormally low levels on the cell surface. This defect can be corrected by the addition of synthetic peptides to the medium bathing the cells, suggesting both that mutation affects the supply of peptides to MHC class 1 molecules and that peptide is required for their maintenance at the cell surface. This was the first indication that MHC molecules are unstable in the absence of bound peptide. Analysis of the DNA of the mutant cells showed that two genes encoding members of the ATP binding cassette, or ABC, family of proteins are mutant or absent in these cells. ABC proteins mediate ATP-dependent transport of ions, sugars, amino acids, and peptides across membranes in many types of cells, including bacteria. The two ABC proteins missing in the mutant cells are normally associated with the endoplasmic reticulum membrane. Transfection of the mutant cells with both genes restores presentation of peptides by the cell's MHC class 1 molecules. These proteins are now called transporters associated with antigen processing 1 and 2, or TAP1 and TAP2. The two TAP proteins form a heterodimer, and mutations in either TAP gene can prevent antigen presentation by MHC class 1 molecules. The genes TAP1 and TAP2 map with the MHC itself and are inducible by interferons, which are produced in response to virus infection. In vitro assays using normal cell fractions, microsomal vesicles that mimic the endoplasmic reticulum will internalize peptides, which then bind to MHC class 1 molecules already present in the microsome lumen. Vesicles from TAP1 or TAP2 mutant cells do not transport peptides. Peptide transport into the normal microsomes requires ATP hydrolysis, proving that the TAP1-TAP2 complex is an ATP-dependent peptide transporter. Such experiments have also shown that the TAP complex has some specificity for the peptides it will transport. It prefers peptides of 8 or more amino acids with hydrophobic or basic residues at the carboxy terminus. The exact features of peptides that bind MHC class 1 molecules. The TAP transporter provides the answer to the question of how viral peptides gain access to the lumen of the endoplasmic reticulum in order to bind to MHC class 1 molecules, but leaves open the question of how these peptides are generated. And that's peptides that bind to MHC class 1 molecules are actively transported from the cytosol to the endoplasmic reticulum. Have a great day.